welcome back.
Hey, Wanakana.
Quick update before the show starts. There will be a blood drive on November 1st. If you want to participate but miss the signups, it's not too late to save a life. Go and see the nurse. This event is sponsored by the GSTA.
Ooh, blood drives are so neat.
I'm scared of needles, but I think it's cool that Wanakana holds one.
Speaking of our good old school, we also just held a court case here. The New Hampshire Supreme Court held oral arguments last week here at Wanakana. The court has been doing this since 2005. But how does this event happen?
Sydney Dunham and Dan Cholfi got a behind-the-scenes look from Broadcast One.
Last week, the New Hampshire Supreme Court made an appearance at Wanakunnet High School as part of a project called On the Road. Many of you attended the event held on Wednesday, so we thought we might show you a glimpse of what lies behind the scenes and what it takes to put on a production like the one you saw. Carol Alfano is the communications manager for the Supreme Court, as well as produces On the Road. We asked her to give us the inside scoop on what it takes to run such an event.
On the Road is a big event. It is the court's signature event, and this takes about a year to make it all happen. So we started planning for Wanakunnet 1 year ago. We have to pick our school. We have to do the site review to make sure the school can handle the event. Wanakunnet is perfect. And then we have to find the case. Finding the cases are very important because, as you can imagine, there are certain cases that are better than others for high school students. We make sure the students get briefed. And the most important thing is our justices get very, very excited for this. So we have to find a host judge, and we have to work with all of the facilities people, the Supreme Court, to make sure we get all of our stuff, because we bring everything. This is all ours. We bring the bench plates. We bring the robes. We have to take the Supreme Court from Concord and set it down here in Hampton.
I work for MFI Productions and Music Factory, and we work with the New Hampshire Supreme Court with the On the Road events, and we provide audio support and lighting and video, sometimes if they need video as well. Generally, the schools will handle video, and we bring in a soundboard and wireless microphones and work to get everything set up with the facilities and the educators. And I've been doing this for about 12 years with them, this particular event, and I do events all over the place and with various organizations. And yeah.
All in all, the New Hampshire Supreme Court felt welcome at Wanakunnet, and the trials ran very smoothly. If you couldn't attend the hearing and wanted to check it out, the video produced by Wanakunnet students will be posted on the New Hampshire Supreme Court's website later this month. For WHTV, this is Dan and Sydney.
That was interesting.
It was. I'm glad I got the chance to see that.
If you know students Adam Richards or Andy Seco, please congratulate them on being selected to be part of the New Hampshire All-State Jazz Festival in February. Andy was selected for the Honors Jazz Choir and Adam for the Jazz Choir. They auditioned this past Saturday along with other students from around the state, and only 16 of each voice part were selected. This is quite an honor.
I love to sing, Kate. My favorite song is the Monster Mash.
I love listening to Halloween music. It gets me in the Halloween spirit.
There are a lot of things you can do to get in the Halloween spirit. Didn't you and Alexis do a story on that?
Yeah, we did. Let's watch it.
Hey, Alexis. Did you know that Halloween originated from an ancient Celtic festival called Samhain, where the people wore costumes to scare away ghosts? And over time, it evolved into the festive holiday that it is today. I am so excited for Halloween. I don't even know what to do with myself.
Well, good thing we talked to some students around the school and asked them their favorite Halloween activities.
Sometimes to get in the Halloween spirit, I'll eat an entire pumpkin raw.
This past weekend, I went to Salem, Massachusetts. It's kind of a good way to get in the Halloween spirit. There was a lot of activities to do. There was an escape room. There was a lot of haunted houses. There was also this coffin that my friends and I tried out, where you can be kind of buried alive.
So I watch horror movies all month long.
I like to watch Halloween movies with Meg Capizzuto.
I went to Scream Fest, and I like to watch Halloween movies.
To get into the Halloween spirit, I carve some pumpkins while wearing, you know, like spooky socks, you know, with the ghost on it and stuff.
We go trick-or-treating every year together.
I go to haunted houses.
This Halloween, I'm planning on playing Call of Duty with my boy Matthew here.
To get in the Halloween spirit, I like to teepee houses, ding-dong ditch houses, do like different satanic rituals, you know, fun light stuff like that.
I like to carve pumpkins with my friend Hannah.
In the fall, I dress up my dog in Halloween costumes.
I like to sneak up behind Brenna and scare her. So to get into the Halloween spirit, I really love to carve pumpkins. And this year, we're finally able to decorate our house so that my children aren't scared. Yesterday, we took them shopping and bought a bunch of skeletons and cobwebs and decorated the house, and they were super excited. So I'm really looking forward to it.
So a lot of people are wondering about this year's Haunted Hotel. It's a really cool activity. It's a great way for the Winnekunnet community to interact with the larger community and local businesses and stuff. So we have a great time doing it every year.
I hope all these ideas get you in the Halloween spirit.
Make sure you get out there and have a spooky Halloween, Winnekunnet.
Halloween is my favorite holiday.
Actually, it's my favorite too.
I love your costume.
Whoa! What was that?
What was what?
Hayden, was that you?
Taylor, what?
I just saw something run behind the cameras.
I don't believe in ghosts.
Oh, I do. Me and Matt even did a story on them.
Roll it.
Whoa! Whoa, whoa.
Did I scare you, Matt?
Yeah, a little bit.
Well, that's good because Halloween's coming up.
I know. People in our school got spooked just like I did.
Yeah, let's check those stories out.
Catherine Desmond's entire house may be haunted.
My house is haunted. Like, I would walk into my room and there would be an impression on my bed as if someone were laying in it, and there wouldn't be anyone there, obviously. It was late at night when we had first moved in, and I just heard from outside like this piercing scream. It sounded like a little child was just screaming at the top of their lungs. I asked my parents and my brother, like, hey, did you hear that noise? Like, was that one of the neighbors? And they had no idea what I was talking about. It was haunted by an 8-year-old boy who, back, I believe, in maybe the 1700s, was playing with his father's gun in the woods, and it combusted in his hands. And I think he died from his wounds. And the house had been moved from where it originally was to where it is now. They said that he like followed the house. I don't want to like upset the ghost, I guess. I don't want to like make it mad by trying to communicate it or like expose it or whatever. It could kill me if it wanted to.
I also heard that Eva Wilcox's house is haunted by two little kid ghosts.
That's so creepy, Taylor.
Me and my friend were taking pictures of my dog the first day we got her, and we were outside. Then like a month later, we were looking through the pictures, and in the background of it, there was two faces. At first, I thought it was like my sister, but then I realized that no one was home when we took it. I thought we like photoshopped it all, but like you couldn't photoshop it. It looked too real. Me and my brother Ollie were in my living room, and we heard the fridge door, and it was like beeping because it was opened, and it sounded like someone was looking through it and like moving stuff in it. And then we looked and no one was there. We think it might be the same ghost as last time. There's a room in my house that's sealed off, and we know it's there, but there's just a window that leads to it. There's no doors.
I also saw a wicked creepy video from one of Jack Shockey's friends.
I don't know if I'm man enough to watch that, Taylor. That sounds really scary.
One of my cousin's friend was dog sitting at one of their neighbor's houses. The owner of the house asked them to like, send a video of them in the house, like safe with the dogs, when they got there and they got in the house. So they took this video, sent it to the owners, and the owner was like, thank you, like, who are you there with? Then she texts back in response, said, I'm just here by myself with the dogs. And the owner responds and says, get out of the house, go back to your home and call 911. So they call the police, police arrive, they go in the house, and they didn't find anyone there, because in the back of the video, you can clearly see like a person or like a shadow like walk through the back of it. It's kind of weird.
Hopefully none of these scary occurrences happen to you.
Happy Halloween, Winnekunnet.
See you next time.
Are you sure you don't believe in ghosts?
Yeah, it's still a no.
Boo! How about now?
No, I still don't believe.
Well, we've got one more story all about haunted places to go.
Maybe it'll scare me. Let's see.
Have you ever wondered what lies beneath the abandoned buildings in your own backyard? Well,
Don't worry, we solve the mystery for you.
Here in New Hampshire, there are many abandoned buildings that have been left to the mercy of nature. Each one has a different story behind why exactly it was left the way it was. Livermore Falls in Camden, New Hampshire is one of these such places. This abandoned structure was once a paper mill located on the Pemigewasset River at Livermore Falls. The mill was abandoned in 1950, and many years later, a flood in 1973 washed through the area, destroying the dam and powerhouse that were once a part of this mill. In addition to the paper mill, Livermore Falls was once home to both a fish hatchery and a hospital as well. In the background, a large bridge that once spanned the entire river can be seen far above the river below. This bridge is now closed to use, but many people have been known to jump from the top and take the 104-foot plunge down into the waters below.
Behind me lies Fort Stark. This fort was built in the late 1700s and remained in action until the World War II era.
Fort Stark was originally built during the time period of the original 13 colonies by the first colonists that came to America. Its purpose was to protect Portsmouth Harbor, which at the time was home to both the naval shipyard and a major shipbuilding industry that was essential to the success of the Navy. The fort remained in action through World War II before becoming a training center for the Navy Reserve and finally being closed for military duty in 1983. With so many forgotten and abandoned buildings around the area, don't shy away from going out and experiencing them on your own. You never know, what you find might just end up surprising you.
Okay, I'm a little spooked. Those are some good WHTV episodes.
WHTV has grown and changed a lot over the years.
This is my first year. Tell me more.
WHTV quietly broke 100,000 views just before the start of the school year. In the channel's first year of existence in 2009, only a few videos were posted online, and the view count at the end of that first 365 days was a meager 1,367. WHTV began its life with a major school renovation in 2005 and 2006. However, the earliest programs were lost when a hard drive crashed. Some of the episodes from 2008 still exist, though. The set was small and randomly decorated, but the heart of what it would become was there, a student-run TV station dedicated to informing and entertaining Winnicott students. The YouTube channel is not far from its 10-year anniversary. The most viewed videos on our channel are our Exeter videos, the Harlem Shake, and One Winnicott. As of today, WHTV has almost 105,000 views.
Super cool. I'll be sure to check those stories out.
Yeah. Happy Halloween! WHTV has almost 100,000. Oh my. Oh, what number is that? As of today. Ah!